Hello students of class 11th, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. Okay students, let us continue with chapter 8, Silk Road, written by Nick Middleton. So dear students, as we have seen that this story written by Nick Middleton, this chapter is about the narrator's journey from slopes of Rabu to Mount Kailash to complete the Kora. To bid him farewell, Lamo gave him a long sleeve, sheepskin coat. He hired Satan's car for his journey and took Daniel along to escort him Dachin. So the protagonist wanted to go to Mount Kailash to complete the Kora. He hired Satan to drive him up to Mount Kora. So as a farewell gift, Lamo gave him a long sleeve, sheepskin coat. He took Daniel as companion till Dachin. When they started the journey, as we have seen in this story, when they started their journey, Satan took a shortcut to southwest. Which was a direct route to Mount Kailash. They had to cross the mountain passes to reach their destination. Satan assured him that it would be, there would be no problem if there would be no snow. So they crossed through few gazelers. Gazelers, I showed you, they are African deers, okay? Gazelers, a herd of wild asses, and shepherd tending the flocks. So they went through these animals. So now students, in our last class, we have discussed in the story that they have started their journey. So what type of obstacles would come in their way? So let us read out the story and come to know. So today, dear students, I am going to read and explain page number 75. Yesterday I read out and explained page number 74. So before moving on, let us write some difficult words and their meanings from this chapter, then I'll read out and explain. Okay, first word is nibbling, NIBBLING. Nibbling means take a small bite from, In mess. Next word is in mess. In mess means in a group. In a group. Bounding means jump, hop, or bounce. Jump, hop, or bounce. Wild ass. An animal who have ears shorter than a horse. An animal who has ears shorter than a horse. Okay. Next word is plumes. 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 Plumes means a quantity of smoke. A quantity of smoke that rises in the air. That rises in the air. Okay. So please note down these words and their meanings. You can also take the screenshot. If it is not visible, so let me turn off the light. Now it is visible. Nibbling means take a small bite from. Okay, I'm asking it is visible actually. A teacher always considers that the students are sitting in front of them. Okay, it's a habit of teaching in classroom. So that is why I'm asking, is it visible now? Okay. Nibbling means take a small bite from. En masse means in a group. Bounding means jump, hop or bounce. Wild ass means an animal who has ears shorter than a horse. Plume means a quantity of smoke that rises in the air. Okay. So I hope you have taken the screenshot. Now look at page number 75. From this paragraph, students, the last paragraph of page number 74. From the gently rolling hills of Rabu, the shortcut took us across vast open plains with nothing in them except a few gazelles. So, from the gently rolling hills of Rabu, the shortcut took them across vast open plains where they could find only gazelles and African or Asian mammals with large eyes that moves quickly and hoofs. So, from the gently rolling hills of Rabu, the shortcut took them across the vast open plains with nothing in them except they came across only by some gazelles that would look up from nibbling the arid pastures and frown before bounding away into the void. So that would look up, those animals were looking up from the nibbling, from when they are taking their bite. The arid means having little or no air. Arid, let me write on the board the meaning of arid. Arid, having little or no air. Okay. Pastures, we know that land covered with grass, meadows. And frown before bounding away into the void. So they passed by these animals, gazelles, which were looking up and nibbling from air, from the space where there was little air or no air, arid pastures. So they were grazing in arid pastures, such meadows where there was no air, and frown before bounding away into the void. So before jumping away into the void, this word we also came across in which chapter? In chapter 5, in which the narrator tells us difference between Chinese and European paintings. Okay, so that this word void also, so it means, void means vacant place. Okay, so into the vacant place, before jumping into the vacant place, so they were, you know, showing their disapproval. Frown means showing disapproval for something. So when narrator went on, he found some gazelers grazing in the pastures, and before jumping, they were showing, they were expressing their disapproval. Further on, where the plains became more stony than grassy, a great herd of wild elk came into view. So dear students, when further, when they reached the plains, when plains became more stony than grassy, now plains became more stony, full of stones, now there were no grasses, there were no grassy, they were now stony. So when they reached at that point where the plains were stony, a great herd of wild ass came into view. They saw a great herd of wild ass, you know, an animal who have no ears. I have just made you right. So they came across wild ass. Satan told us that we were approaching them long before they appeared. So Satan already informed them that they were about to reach to these animals, these void as. So before reaching, before narrators and narrator and other Daniel, you know, could see these wild ass, so before they could see, Satan informed them that they were to see those wild ass. Okay, Kyang, he said, and they were called Kyang. Pointing towards a far off pile of dust, far off, you know, a gathering of dust, he pointed and showed narrator those animals, those wild ass, wild ass. When we drew near, I could see the herd galloping en masse. When narrator reached nearer, he found the group of wild ass was galloping, was jumping in a group. They were galloping in a group, wheeling and turning in right formation as if they were practicing manoeuvres on some predetermined course. Yes, so narrator tells us that he saw them, he saw those wild as they were, the way they were galloping, it looked like they were practicing, like a, you know, military exercises. So they were exercising like a military. Okay, so they were practicing something pre-planned military exercises. Okay, so the way they were galloping, it seemed that they were practicing as a, you know, military exercise. Plumes of dust billowed into the crisp clean air. Then plumes, a quantity of smoke that rises in the air. So a quantity of dust billowed. Billowed means, you know, filled with air. A quantity of dust filled with air was, you know, pleasantly, which was pleasantly hard and dry. It was mixing in the clean air. So the narrator is telling us what was the scene there. So when they were moving on, they came across gazelers, then they came across wild ass. So they were galloping. The way they were galloping, it was a perfect formation, which was showing that they were exercising at a military. They were practicing for a course, predetermined course. As hills started to push up once more from the rocky wilderness, we passed solitary drokebars tending their flocks. So as hills started to push up once more from the rocky wilderness, so once again when they reached rocky wilderness, they passed solitary means alone drokebars tending their flocks. So they were leading their flocks, sometimes men, sometimes women. These well wrapped figures would pause and state at our car, occasionally waving as we passed. So when they were passing, so sometimes they were coming across men, sometimes they were coming across women. These well wrapped figures would pause and state at our car. So when they looked stare. So they would pause and they looked attentively at narrator's car as if they wanted to bid them a farewell. As well as his companions a goodbye, a farewell. Drokebars means shepherd. I made you right. I told you drokebars. I showed you also yesterday in my last video. I showed you in the MS, in my previous video, I showed you in the MS about drokebars. When the track took us close to their animals, the sheep would take evasive action, wearing away from the speeding vehicle. So when their car was close to their animals, the sheep would take evasive action. They were evasive action means action which is taken to save themselves. So they were taking action to save themselves, wearing away from the speeding vehicle. So they were changing their direction, wearing away from the speeding vehicle. In order to save themselves, they were changing their direction suddenly. So wearing means to change direction suddenly. Wearing means to change direction suddenly. Okay, to change direction suddenly. Where? So I hope you have written this word and its meaning. So narrator tells us how these sheep were trying to save themselves from speeding car, from their car. We passed nomads' dark tents pitched in splendid isolation. The narrator passed nomads. We know very well what nomads. Nomads are the people who, you know, patch up their tent at a place, then after some days another place. They do not, you know, stay at the same place. They keeps on changing their place. Okay, so they are nomads. You must have come across this word in history. Okay, so they passed nomads' dark tents pitched in splendid isolation. So they found nomads' dark tents. They were pitched in, you know, splendid isolation means very alone, at a distance. They were patched in very alone. Okay, it was a splendid isolation. Usually with the huge black dog, a Tibetan mastiff standing guard. So usually with a huge black dog, so usually with a huge black dog, a Tibetan mastiff. You know, Tibetan mastiff is also a breed of a dog. Okay, it's a breed of a dog which is very dangerous. They are very dangerous kind of dogs. Okay, so usually with a, so these tents were guarded by usually with a huge black dog, a Tibetan mastiff, a Tibetan, you know, breed of dog, a Tibetan mastiff. They are very sharp, very dangerous dog. Okay, they were guarding their tents. Standing guard, these beasts would cock their great big heads when they became aware of our approach and fix us in their sights. So these animals, these beasts, these animals would cock their great big heads. They move their big heads when they became aware of our approach. When they became aware of narrator's approach, so they were moving their heads and fix us in their sights. And they were, you know, fixing their sights. They were staring to the narrator's car. So they were looking attentively towards narrator's car as they were guarding the tents of nomads. So these are Tibetan mastiff, a variety of Tibetan dog, a breed of Tibetan dog. They are very dangerous. They are very, you know, their height also, they are very big in height. Okay, as we continued to draw closer, they would explode into action. So when the narrator were moving ahead, so they were, you know, bursting with loud noise, explode. They were bursting with a loud noise. They started barking, speeding directly towards her, towards you know, narrator, in front of narrator's car. They were attacking narrator's car. When narrator moved on, so those dogs were running towards narrator's car. They were barking. They were, you know, as if they were attacking narrator's car. Like a bullet from a gun and nearly as fast. So they were attacking as if a bullet from the gun attacks. So the same way those dogs were attacking to narrator's car. So dear students, as of now we have seen that the narrator has started his journey to complete his Kora to Mount Kailash. He was bid farewell by Lama. Lama also gifted him you know, sheepskin coat. So when narrator moved on with, he hired Satan's car, okay, Satan was driving the car. One more person he hired till, you know the name of the place, here, till Dachin, and then these three persons then moved away. When they went ahead, first of all they saw gazelles, African or Asian animal, so which were grazing there. Further they found wild ass. Then later they found the tents of nomads, which were guarded by these Tibetan mastiff dogs, dangerous dogs. These dogs were attacking to narrator's car violently. Okay, so let's see what happened next in the story. These shaggy monsters, these Tibetan mastiff, these shaggy monsters, blacker than the darkest night. These dogs, they were blacker than the darkest night. Usually wore bright red collars and barked furiously with massive jaws. Violently they were barking with massive jaws. Their jaws were massive, great, big. They were completely fearless of our vehicles. So they were completely fearless of narrator's car, narrator's vehicle. They did not afraid of narrator's car. Shooting straight into our path, causing Satan to break and swear. So swerve means to change direction suddenly. Swerve, swerve, swerve means to change direction direction suddenly. So they were causing Satan to apply brake and to change the car's direction suddenly. Now turn on next page. The dog would make chase for 100 meters or so before easing off. So before leaving, before giving up those dogs, they chased 100 meters or so. They chased 100 meters or more than it before giving up, before leaving them. So here easing off means leave. Easing off means leave. E-A-S-I-N-G. Easing off means leave. Before leaving, okay? Before leaving them, they chased about 100 meters. Having seen us off the property, when they found that narrator's car now had moved beyond their property, ahead of their property, then they left. Then they stopped, chasing them. It wasn't difficult to understand why ferocious Tibetan mastiffs became popular in China's imperial courts as hunting dogs brought along the Silk Road in ancient times as tribute from Tibet. Now imperial. Imperial means royal. Imperial. Imperial means royal. Okay. Imperial means royal. So dear students, the narrator says that now it wasn't difficult to understand why ferocious Tibetan mastiffs became popular in China's imperial court. Now it was not difficult for narrator to understand why these Tibetan mastiffs were so popular in Chinese royal courts as hunting dogs, brought along the Silk Road in ancient times at tribute from Tibet, and they must have been brought from Tibet through Silk Road, okay, as a tribute. So suddenly remembered the ancient times when these Tibetan dogs used to be the guards of imperial. They were popular in China's imperial. They were popular in China's royal courts as hunting dogs. They were brought along the Silk Road in ancient times as tribute from Egypt. Now look at the next paragraph. By now we could see snow-capped mountains gathering on the horizon. So now narrator could see snow-capped mountains gathering on the horizon. Horizon means, student, a place from where it seems that sun is rising. So behind the mountain you could see a place where it seems that the sun is rising, just behind the place. This place is called horizon. Okay, this place is called horizon. So students, by now we could see snow-capped mountains gathering on the horizon. So now narrator reached to snow-capped mountains gathering on this point, on horizon. We entered a valley where the river was wide and mostly clogged with ice, brilliant white in glinting in the sunshine. So now they reached a place where the river was wide and mostly clogged with ice, filled with ice and brilliant white, and it was shining in the sunshine. Glinting means shining. The trail hugged its bank, twisting with meanders. So the trails, the road which was through which they were going, it was passing along with the bank of the river, and it was twisting with the meanders. Meanders means twist and turn slope of a river. Twist and turn slope of a river, that is meander. Meanders means twist and turn slope of a river. Okay, then they reached the they were moving along the twist and turn slopes of the river. As we gradually gained height and the valley sides closed in. So now they were gradually, now they were gaining height, and the now valley sides closed in. So when they were gaining height, so valley gradually, the valley side was closing, it could not be seen. Okay, so it's all about today's video, students. In my next video, I'll explain the next two pages of this chapter. So thank you, students, for watching the video. See you tomorrow.